Alrighty, folks. Like I said before, this is going to be this actual video is going to be on diesel engines. Now, diesel engines are a little bit different than gasoline. Of course, it's because we have different fuels, of course, but there is some basic differences. One, as we spoke about in the gasoline engine, which really would be over in your gaseous fuels and stuff like that, we have a spark ignition system, whereas diesel is going to use a compression ignition. So keep that in mind when we kind of start going over this topic. And I want to go ahead and jump right into the screen share. And let's see, I've got it right here. And I want to go ahead and start my actual slide presentation. So, like I said, this is, you know, chapter 19, if you've got the book, and it would be a good idea to kind of review it. I'm going to go kind of lightly over it because diesel engines have, and gasoline engines do too, they have some complexity to it, but we're kind of going to give you an overview of the differences, and I'll try to get a comparison going on between the two, and what the advantages and disadvantages of you know, diesel versus gasoline. One of the things, gasoline is more prominent. I'm not saying that diesel isn't one of the big hitters also, and we use a lot of diesel engines in cranes and big rigs, heavy-duty equipment, and we do that because diesels put out quite a considerable amount of torque. This is really key to when we and fire departments use diesels because diesel engines don't have the downside of having to have some kind of spark ignition happen. Whereas the gasoline engines, if the spark doesn't work, the engine doesn't run. Where diesel engines, because they use spark, compression ignitions, they don't need that spark. All they need is a little bit of heat. We'll talk about how that works in just a second here. So you'll notice here that I don't have a spark plug. This is the one of the biggest differences. We do have valves like we did in the gasoline motor, and we do still have the four-stroke cycle, just like we did with the gasoline. But now we are going to use the compression heat. So we're going to actually take an air charge only in. Okay, we're not going to put any fuel into it. Actually, there are some gasoline motors that we'll talk more when we get into our actual fuel injection section of this class. And I'll kind of show you a little bit about how that works. Now, as far as getting the fuel into the cylinder, gasoline took, and I pretty much said that gasoline robbed this from diesel because diesel's always done it this way. This injection is right into the cylinder. So this is direct injection. And you're going to hear in gasoline world, hey, our cars are direct injected. That means they, instead of pushing the fuel behind an intake valve, they're actually going to push it right into the cylinder. So you'll learn more about this as you get into your diesel type classes and stuff like that too. But it'll inject right into it when as it comes up to the top dead center part. You know, one of the biggest differences between gasoline and diesel is gasoline, like I said earlier, the compression ratios could be somewhere around 8.5 to 12.5 to 1. Whereas diesel, you could have 18, 23, 25 to 1. In other words, we're going to get a really tight squeeze. And that's how they heat up that air. When that air gets really super hot, then they're going to just squirt a little bit. Really, it's a really fine mist of diesel fuel. And that's what causes the fuel to burn. And that explosion that happens throws down that piston. Now, early on, diesels had a prominent rattle noise to them that gasoline didn't have. They've gotten much better at it through different technology to keep that rattling sound down so diesels don't sound as loud. But you can still, if you listen closely enough, you can actually hear that going on. So again, some lot of similarities, but some differences. You know, the compression ratio, how we actually get it, the fuel to burn is a little bit different. This is just one of the setups, and it's kind of showing the fuel system on this particular one. We are not going to really be covering fuel systems in as far as diesel. We'll talk about them in gasoline, but it kind of gives you an idea of some differences. We have an injector that injects right into the cylinder here. If we come from the right to the left, we do have cams just like we do in a gasoline engine. But here we're actually pulling the fuel through here. And here's our injection pump. We go from a kind of a lift pump here. It's kind of, you know, probably going a little bit over your head, maybe not. And then we kind of pressurize it to a high pressure and go through this common rail to our injectors and bringing it on through. But you'll kind of get it when we get to more of the fuel system stuff like that. So this is kind of going a little farther on to what kind of materials they use in the actual world of gasoline versus diesel. And here, you know, cast iron, very heavy duty on the block, it has to be. And then we have cast iron or aluminum blocks. We usually, we kind of go more sort of cast iron, but you know, cast type. And then our cylinder heads are pretty much the same, but look at the difference in the ratio right here. Right here, like I said before, peak engine RPM, about 2,500. We can go up to 8,000 RPM on cars. Again, you know, that has to do with the power thing, but remember that the diesel engine has quite a considerable amount more torque. The pistons are aluminum, you know, and then they have different setups with them as they go along. This next kind of picture here shows the, you know, the diesel engine with the pistons inside of it. Now, one of the things that, yes, we can actually put a turbocharger or a supercharger on gasoline motors, but the diesel engine is very reliant on the turbo. This turbo needs to be in place or the diesel engine does not run very well. We want to put a lot of air inside of it so we can bring up that volume of air in, or I should say that oxygen in there, so it can then squeeze and put a lot of heat as we go along like that. Then we have the engine block. You know, I didn't have a really good picture of it in the gasoline one, but now you can see what the engine block kind of looks like. And then the cylinder head goes up on top, and this is all the intake piping for the actual air going into the actual engine itself. This is what a piston, it's more, sturdy. It's very, rods are a lot thicker and stronger because the explosion in them is a lot more violent. And then the pistons, the piston heads are much larger in shape. And this is just a 5.9. And when you get into the bigger equipment, I'll try to find it, but I actually had a picture of an actual guy in a boat diesel engine that you actually had to walk down inside to service it. It wasn't, you lean over the hood, but you actually had to be, craned down inside to work on some of the stuff. It's very big equipment. My uncle, Porter, he actually worked at the shipyards and worked on some of these motors. And, you know, I mean, they were huge. If you ever get a chance, go to the Queen Mary down in Long Beach and kind of go through the actual engine room, and you're going to see the sizes of the engine and the actual, you know, connecting rods and stuff like that as we go along. All right, so here is one style of of actual injection. Like I said, the diesel engines don't have spark plugs, but they do to get the temperature of the cylinder to increase enough for it to support combustion first thing in the morning. And this is primarily first thing in the morning. We have either a heating grid or we'll have a glow plug. This glow plug, its main job is to heat up the cylinder. This one actually is heating up the prechamber. This prechamber is one style of injection. And then this particular one, we kind of spray a fairly rich mixture into the prechamber, and that'll lead over to the other chamber, which is the combustion chamber, which is down below here. So here's your pre-chamber, and this is the other combustion chamber that you see right down here. This is what's going to cause, you know, the bigger, you know, just where the bigger explosion is going to happen, and it's going to slam that piston on down. Again, our intake valve will have an exhaust valve also, and here's our piston. This is a normal, you know, direct injection type system that goes right into the cylinder. You notice how the piston is shaped differently than the gasoline one is also. We're actually a lot of squeeze going on, and we have to make some room for some kind of a chamber motion on it like that. This next slide is not really, it is important, but it's, you know, into this class, not really that greatly important, but I just wanted to point out they do some testing on some of these sensors. This is a temp sensor that's down in the fuel tank. And one of the things that is the downside of diesel fuel is it can grow algae, different types of bacteria and stuff like into the fuel. If the fuel gets very cold, the fuel can actually sludge. Generally, trucks don't do it because they go through, it's just the algae and bacteria, because they go through fuel pretty quickly. But if you have a vehicle that sits for a long period of time, say you're a rock star and your actual rig is sits for months at a time before you go on to another tour, or you don't tour in the trailer anymore. You go on a flight and it sits for a long period of time. This kind of stuff can grow. The other thing that can happen with diesel fuel too is that if you get into very cold climates, the diesel fuel can actually solidify and kind of sludge a little bit, and it can actually plug up lines. So they'll have heaters down inside the fuel tanks to keep that from actually happening. So these temperature sensors will kind of trigger and let the computer know, or a heater know, that, hey, you need to turn on so that we can actually keep it from actually, sludging up our fuel lines and all. And another thing too, gasoline will absorb water, but getting water into a diesel is really, really bad. So we have filters in lines, small filters for the injectors, but we also have filters for the fuel coming through. We'll have water separators also in the system as we go along too. And you'll notice, we have steel lines because of the high pressures that we're going to be putting the fuel through. And this is another type of injection system. I leave this in here for my diesels type classes. And another one kind of showing you how some of them are actually laid out. This is an actual injector. It shows the seals. This would be an O-rings that go down inside. You don't see them there because they cut them away, so you can actually see the actual cavity the O-rings sit into. And the injectors are actually, they used to be mechanical injectors, now they're actually electrical injectors, and these are computerized injectors now. And they do have to be indexed, and actually the computer needs to know what injectors where nowadays. And that takes scan tools and some other knowledge on how to do this. So the injector layout and how the injector's made, this is, of course, the spring that's inside of it. It keeps the pendle, right down here at the nozzle. The nozzle pendle's closed, and then we use a electric magnetism to actually move this up and down, and causing that injector nozzle to open up. Different types of glow plug assortment. This is an assortment that actually put in there the different threads for the different glow plugs that are in there in different models. And then, of course, it used to be, like I said, all mechanical. Now it is actually electronic. So we're actually talking computer-wise and how it actually works. And then also on our glow plugs, we actually have relays and different devices to turn those glow plugs on and off. Here is a heating grid picture. Some of the systems don't use a glow plug. They'll actually use a heating grid, and it'll heat up the intake air as it comes inside. All right, so that is kind of my little quick spiel on diesel engines. There's a lot more to them, but I wanted you to know the difference that here a diesel engine is going to be compression ignition. There's not going to be a spark plug. There will be glow plugs or heating grid, but that's only to warm up the air to get it started first thing in the morning or when the vehicle cools down. And on a gasoline engine or your CNG or compressed natural gas, your propanes, some of your other alternate fuels that are out there, it's going to be an actual spark ignition. The spark ignition is different, but instead of using compression, which gasoline is more volatile than diesel. I'm not saying that you can't burn diesel. If it's squeezed hard enough and it's sprayed into a very fine mist, it can burn. Whereas gasoline, all I need to do is throw gasoline down on the ground, light a match, and that's up in flames. I take that same amount of diesel fuel, throw it down there, and it's not going to light very readily because it's more of an oily type base. It's just the different properties of the two. So we can't squeeze our gasoline as tightly as we can with a diesel engine. All right. And the parts on them are heavier and usually bigger on a diesel than it is on a gasoline motor. So, and we use more of the diesel in the heavy duty equipment. Not saying we don't do it in some of the light duty equipment. You get your medium duty trucks, you get some of your diesel cars that will use a diesel engine in them too, but this is going to be more of your lighter diesel makeups as we go along. Okay, very good. I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing right now, and I bid you a good day, and I hope you have a great time and look forward to my next video that I'm going to be putting up on the next subject for next week. All right, take care of yourself, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.